pertanyaan paling sering gue dengar adalah gimana sih mulai in terms of work ya? Tapi before that, I was raised in a place where I need to accomplish something that's not easy. So after college, this is the things. Who knows the things? Okay, believe it or not, my first project was thrown at things. I'm not an architect, I'm not an interior designer. So gue dapet job, tiba-tiba, lu bikin dong ini cafe sama warnet. Zaman dulu masih warnet, saya udah tua, jadi maafin untuk anak-anak yang muda. Warnet kan musim, udah ada musim. Tapi karena saya gak punya background buat gambar, akhirnya, so, yaudah, digambar di sini. Terus ada tombol screenshot, and I presented it to the client. So that's my first job. And then, tiba-tiba aku nanya, why? Kenapa jadi tukang kebun? Why leaves? Tapi sebelum menjawab itu, I need to share about something. Since I was little, I was taught by my family to share, to live, to share. So ever since on my birthdays, instead of going out with my friends, celebrating at McDonald's or KFC, which is sudah zaman gue muda belum ada ya, celebrate lain lagi. Terus my family would bring me to the village, and they were like, kita bagi-bagi. So it's like, my mom always said, one good deed of life can determine your life. One small good deed can change your life. So that's why it's like, anywhere I go, whatever the situation I'm in, I need to find a way that I can be comfortable in. I can share, or I can, yeah, like the part, like judulnya ya, innovate. Mungkin gue gak inovatif seperti orang-orang yang nemuin listrik, yang nemuin aset, atau which is gue gak bisa hidup tanpa aset, atau yang nemuin lampu. Tapi for me, innovation is different for each person. For me, each and every day, if you can innovate a way to be comfortable with yourself and others, to live your life the way you want it to be, is already innovative. For me, if you can do that, then I'll guarantee from time to time, from day to day, you will survive and you can do well. There are moments when you know the real story, right? Life is sometimes up, life is sometimes down. It's not always up, I mean. I started really hard. So, growing in the traditional family, we are obligated to follow our parents, right? So, mungkin pernah nonton dekat atau sebelah? Apa sih? Atau sebelah ya, cek atau sebelah ya. Nah, mungkin itu reflection of my life ketika udah lulus, diharapkan untuk jadi toko dan menolak. Jadi di situ struggle-nya tuh mulai. Tapi cari cara, gimana cara berhasil? How can I make this work? How can I make this work? So mulai cari, but it's not easy. For 2 years, my own dad is just like, gue punya anak bodoh. Harusnya dia jadi bos atau kakak di toko. Tapi dia malah nyangkul di pun orang. Nyangkul as if nyangkul, karena I started from zero. Back at the time, gak punya staff, gak punya pegawai, jadi semuanya sendiri. Terus, the challenge is going as our, as we try to grow, the challenge is growing as well. Di situ mulai ketika bikin satu company, had a chance to go to Bali, yang namanya baru bikin startup, terus ada tawaran ke Bali. Siapa sih yang gak mau? Siapa sih yang gak suka Bali? Semua suka Bali kan pasti. Semua mikir, oke, Bali, hidup di pantai. Oh, udah. Me in my 20s was like, okay, let's go to Bali. And then I was like, whoa, Bali is not as sweet as I imagined. We go on holiday to Bali, right? But if you live in Bali, yeah, it's different. So in Bali, I had a hard time because I was like having a partner and ketipu di sana, basically. Mulai, cari nama, dibawa ke Bali, masa gagal nih. I'm from Bandung actually, jadi kayak orang-orang Bandung, oh kayak selagi dari Bali. Tapi little that they know, itu gue di Bali struggle parah. Sampai itu bisa dibilang 2012 adalah turning point of my life. Di situ gue belajar, kok hidup gak segampang ini ya? Ternyata ya selama ini udah gue build, itu gak gampang. Hanya karena once to be mistake, karena I trusted the wrong person. Nah, disitulah gue langsung mikir, gimana nih caranya? Get out from the situation and try to grow. Karena at that time, gue sudah merokok. Gue udah ninggalin semua kayak gue di Bali. Dan di Bali gue ngomong, jadi ya udah. Start from zero. Back in January 2012, I was in a point where I only have 500,000 rupiah in my bank account. I have two options, buy gas or eat. So at the time, I called a friend. I was like, can I borrow 500,000? Why? You never borrow a penny in your life. I was like, okay, I just need it. So from that turning point of life, I was like, okay, kita harus nyoba lagi, dan harder and harder. We need to try harder. So kayak biji yang udah tertaruh ke tanah, belum tentu tanahnya itu kan bagus dan belum tentu biji itu bisa hidup. Tapi di sini kita harus gimana caranya si biji ini hidup. Jadi kita nggak bisa hidup benar, kita nggak bisa jalanin usaha yang benar atau apapun tanpa apa yang benar. Untuk sampai saat ini pun bisa dibilang menurut gue juga benar. Tapi I'm trying, we're trying to go there. Jadi no matter what you do, just believe in yourself. Try to do it. Tadi ada yang ngomong kayak orang yang terberkati adalah yang bisa hidup dari hobi. I'm one of them and I'm blessed for that. Jadi sekarang udah ada di momen ketika okay, the hard work is paying off now. Kita mulai ada nama, kita udah mulai ngomongin dari job, kita udah mulai nggak ribet lagi. Tapi the biggest question, balik lagi the biggest question, kenapa gardener? Coba di sini siapa yang mau jadi gardener? That's a single hand. Okay, next question. What if I tell you that my average project per house is 200 million rupiah per gardener? Siapa yang mau jadi gardener? Different, right? So yeah, that's right. What I'm trying to say is that sometimes you cannot just the book by its cover. You cannot just tell itu profesi apa, which is what you do in life. It reflects just not on words basis, but it reflects on how every day, how we look and how we dress up is important for every day. But now since okay, kita balik lagi sekarang udah mulai ada nama dan sebagainya, orang-orang udah mulai mikir ternyata yang dibilang yang dilihat sebelah mata itu ada juga ya hasilnya. Jadi sekarang lebih mikir kayak okay, what's next, what can we do next, because there's always more to come. We're always learning, we are student. Kita jadi murid seumur hidup, nggak ada yang namanya kita udah lulus. Kita nggak pernah lulus dari kita. Namanya kehidupan itu selalu growing, ataupun kan grow. Jadi seperti biji yang tadi, anggaplah dia udah jatuh ke tanah, dia udah mulai munculin akarnya dan akarnya udah kuat, dia udah mulai nih jadi pohon dan dia udah mulai berbuah. What's the next step? Kalau for me, gue gak tau kalau buat orang-orang lain, tapi for me, karena gue dididik untuk share. My mom and dad was like sharing. Jadi langsung mikir, ketika sekarang gue udah nyampe posisi yang oke, udah cukup, karena ini udah ya. What's next adalah, gue sekarang lagi mencoba untuk share. Jadi startup company is always hard. 1% dari startup company yang berhasil, sisanya ya, buang, it's always a time, it's always a money. Tapi what I'm trying to say is that don't give up. No matter what people say, lu gak akan berhasil, lu gak akan bisa. Itu, I've been living with that for years. Many years. And now, after all the hard work, sekarang kita bisa tarik buahnya. Sekarang kita bisa bilang, I've accomplished this. I've made this. Who am I? I'm still a student. I'm still learning. But how to share the fruit, how to share what we have, and how to share what we got for all these years is in your hands. It's, everybody has their own ways. Bebas mau caranya gimana, tapi let's find a way. Jadi kita cari jalan gimana caranya kita bisa nyaman di semua challenge yang ada di kehidupan sehari-hari. Tapi juga kita harus cari jalan gimana caranya kita udah nyaman dan kita udah sukses. Kita harus bikin orang-orang yang berusaha untuk nyaman dan orang